In calculus of residues, till now we have discussed the residue theorem, that is Cauchy residue theorem, which actually states that if a function f of z is analytic within and on a simple closed curve C, then integral of f of z along the closed curve C in sense anti-clockwise sense is equal to 2 pi I into sum of the residues at all the isolated singular points inside the closed curve C. Now today we are going to discuss some of its important applications. In fact, we will deal with three types of applications in evaluating the integrals of real variables using this residue theorem. In this first lecture on application of residues to evaluate integrals of real variables, we will discuss actually the integrals round a unit circle which is of this type defined in this equation A. That is, we have to evaluate using the Cauchy residue theorem the integral I equal to 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta sin theta d theta. Actually, in this integral, the function f of cos theta sin theta is actually a rational function of either cos theta or sin theta or both. But remember, this function f of cos theta sin theta does not contain any isolated singularities other than the poles. So let us start how to find such type of integral using the Cauchy residue theorem. So first of all, we will learn about the technique for the evaluation of such type of integrals, and then we will illustrate such technique by taking some important examples. So first of all, let us see what is the technique to solve this type of integral. Actually, for the evaluation of this type of integral, first of all, we change the integral or transform the integral into a complex line integral. And for converting such type of integral into a complex line integral, we consider a unit circle. When you say unit circle, it means a circle having radius 1 and its center is at z equal to 0. So to evaluation of such integrals, we transform this integral into a line integral, line integral of complex variable z. You can see actually the given integral will be in terms of the real variables, but we will transform that integral into a line integral of complex variable z. And how this integral can be transformed into a line integral of complex variable? I have told you, we have to assume a unit circle having center at z equal to 0. Let us see, this is a unit circle and its center is at z equal to 0. And if it is a unit circle, you know what will be its equation. So take a unit circle unit circle, let us say C, given as, you know how we define a unit circle having center at z equal to 0. This is defined as mod of z equal to 1, or you can say z equal to e to the power I theta. So in all problems of this type, we have to take a unit circle, because as I have told you, this, in fact, these are integrals around a unit circle. So always we consider a unit circle defined by this equation z equal to e to the power I theta. From here we can actually found what will be d theta in terms of z. So therefore you can see dz will be equal to I e to the power I theta d theta. And so that we may write d theta equal to, and first of all let us see, this e to the power I theta is z, so we can write it as I z d theta. And so you can write d theta equal to what? This will be dz over I z. And you know 1 over I is minus I, so we can write it minus I dz over z. So you can see this d theta has been changed in terms of dz. Now in our problem, the function given will be either a function of cos theta or sin theta or both. So we have to change those cos theta and sin theta also in terms of z. So how we will transform it, you can see, you know that cos theta is equal to e to the power I theta plus e to the power minus I theta divided by 2. And from here you can see e to the power I theta, this is actually z, and e to the power minus I theta, this is 1 over z. So you can write it as z square plus 1 over 2z. So in this way cos theta is transformed into in terms of the complex variable z. Similarly, we can also transform sin theta in terms of complex variable z in this way. You can see sin theta is what? You know it is given as e to the power I theta minus e to the power minus I theta over 2i. And so we can write it 1 over 2i into e to the power I theta is z, and e to the power minus I theta is 1 over z. And so from here you can see this sin theta is equal to z square minus 1 over 2i. So in this way we transform these cos theta and sin theta involved in the problem in terms of the complex variable z. So now we can write the given integral I, which is actually given in this form, integral 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta sin theta d theta. And you can see that this integral may be written as, how we can write this integral? We can write it in this manner as dz has been d theta has been changed in terms of dz as minus I dz by z. So this minus I being a constant will be out of the integral, and we take the integral along the unit circle C in anti-clockwise sense, and this will be f of cos theta. Instead of cos theta, we will write z square plus 1 over 2. And sin theta, instead of sin theta, we will write z square minus 1 over 2i. And d theta, this is actually minus I dz by z. I have already taken minus I, so here will be dz by z. So in this way, we can define this integral in terms of the function of complex variable. So now this integral defined in equation B, you can see, may be evaluated by using the concept of residues or calculus of residues. That is, actually we will solve this integral by applying the Cauchy residue theorem. So you can say, now the integral in B is evaluated by applying Cauchy residue theorem. Actually, you have studied already Cauchy residue theorem, and this theorem states that this I will be equal to what? Here you can see this f of this much is at the place of f of z. So, and this minus I is just a common factor, and so we will actually write this integral in accordance with Cauchy integral theorem equal to minus I into 2 pi I. This is just a statement of Cauchy residue theorem, and summation, you know, j equal to 1 to n. Actually, there are n isolated singular points inside the closed curve C here, and here the closed curve is actually a unit circle, and sum of the residues minus a minus 1, this is in fact residue at all the singular points zj. So using this formula or this theorem, we will actually evaluate such type of integrals. So this is the working rule. Now we will illustrate this working rule by taking some important examples. So let us take first example. Using the calculus of residues. Evaluate the integral I equal to integral 0 to 2 pi d theta over 2 plus cos theta. You can see this problem is just in the form of as we have learnt this in working rule. So first of all, we will consider a unit circle. So consider a unit circle, let us say C, and this unit circle is defined as how? You know, this is defined as z equal to e to the power I theta, and therefore you can see from here this dz will be what? This is I e to the power I theta d theta, but this e to the power I theta is equal to z, so this is I z d theta. We have already learnt it, and so from here this d theta will be equal to dz over I z, and we can write it minus I dz by z. So in this way we actually transform this d theta in terms of dz. Now we will transform the function cos theta in terms of z. We have just learnt that what is cos theta in terms of z. You have seen that this cos theta is actually equal to what? This is z square plus 1 over 2z. As you can see here, we have already mentioned, actually here will be z2. This is 2z. So we have seen that this cos theta is equal to z square plus 1 over 2z. Now you can write this integral I equal to integral 0 to 2 pi d theta by 2 plus cos theta in terms of the complex variable z. And so what will be the integral? Therefore we can write I equal to integral 0 to 2 pi d theta by 2 plus cos theta. And now we can write it integral around the unit circle C in anti-clockwise sense and d theta over 2 plus cos theta. What will be this? You can see this is 1 over 2 plus cos theta, and we have seen that this cos theta is what? This is actually z square plus 1 over 2z. And at the place of d theta, what will be the result? This is actually dz, or you can say minus i dz by z. So you can see this I may be written as integral along the unit circle C in anti-clockwise sense, and let us take this minus I outside of the integral because it is a constant factor. So this will be simply minus I integral around C, and this will be 1 over, let us take here actually the LCM, and so you can see from here this will be z square plus 4z plus 1 into dz by z, and this 2z factor will be in fact in numerator, so this is 2z. So here this z and z will cancel out, and our integral is transformed into the form minus 2i integral along C 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1 dz. Let us consider this is equation 1. You can see here this integral is actually in the form of integral along a unit circle of a function f of z. So let f of z is equal to 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1. So to evaluate this integral, you can see we have to evaluate actually integral of f of z along this unit circle. And for evaluating it by the concept of calculus of residues, first of all, we will find the poles of this function f of z. So to find poles of f of z, we take how the poles are found. Actually, poles are found by equating the denominator to 0. So for finding the pole, we take this denominator, that is z square plus 4z plus 1 equal to 0. You can see this is actually a quadratic equation, and so we can find the roots of this quadratic equation. And therefore, you can write what will be this z. This z will be, as the formula says, minus b. Here at the place of b there is 4, so this will be minus 4 plus minus root over b square, and b is 4, so b square will be 16 minus 4ac. A is 1 and c is also 1, so there will be minus 4 over 2a. A is 1, so this will be over 2. Now you can see this is minus 4 plus minus root over 12 over 2, and you can write it minus 4 plus minus 2 root over 3. Root 12 may be written as 2 into root over 3 and over 2. And so this will be what? This is minus 2 plus minus root over 3. So as it is the roots of a quadratic equation, so you can see actually this will be a product of two factors in the form of x minus alpha into x minus beta, or x plus alpha into x plus beta, where alpha beta are actually the roots of the equation. And so the power content in the factors determining the poles will be 1, and so these are actually the simple poles or poles of order 1. So you can see this function f of z has two simple poles. And what are those simple poles? So f of z, which is actually equal to 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1, has two simple poles. Remember, these are simple poles because we have found it by the roots of a quadratic equation. So two simple poles which are, what are actually those simple poles? Those are z equal to minus 2 plus root 3 and minus 2 minus root 3. Now we can see actually this first pole, minus 2 plus root 3, this will be actually inside the unit circle, and this pole, that is minus 2 minus root 3, is actually outside of the unit circle. You can see this in this figure. If we consider a unit circle in the complex plane having center at z equal to 0, this is z equal to 0 and this is our unit circle, and this is a real axis, or you can say this is x axis, this is imaginary axis, or you can say this is I y axis or imaginary axis. So what the poles are where located, you can see this is minus 2 plus root 3, because this will be as a whole negative but real. So these two poles are on the real axis in negative side, and this is the position of the second pole, which is actually minus 2 minus root 3. And you can see from this figure, because the radius of the circle is 1, and this number, the modulus of this number is less than 1, and modulus of this number is greater than 1. So this will be inside the circle and this is outside of the circle. So only one pole, which is z equal to minus 2 plus root 3, is inside this unit circle, and the another pole is outside. So there is no need to find the residue of the function f of z at this another pole, which is outside of the circle. We have only to evaluate residue of the function f of z at this pole minus 2 plus root 3. So only the pole z equal to minus 2 plus root 3 is inside the unit circle, unit circle C. And if only this point is inside the unit circle C, then we need only to evaluate the residue of the function f of z at this pole z equal to minus 2 plus root 3. Since the pole is a simple pole or first order, so we will apply the formula for finding the residue in case of a simple pole. So you can say, so a residue of f of z, and f of z has been already defined here, at its simple pole, simple pole z equal to minus 2 plus root 3. This will be actually given as a minus 1. In case of simple pole, you know the working formula for finding the residue. This is limit z tends to z naught, where z naught is actually the simple pole inside the closed curve, and here actually the simple pole is at z equal to this much. So we will write z tends to minus 2 plus root 3. And here inside the bracket we write z minus z naught, and z naught is minus 2 plus root 3. So this will be actually z plus 2 minus root 3. This is at the place of z minus z naught into, you know, f of z. And what is this f of z? This f of z is actually 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1. Now we will simplify this. You can see this is limit z tending towards minus 2 plus root 3. And we can write it z plus 2 minus root 3 over. Now the factor in denominator, that is z square plus 4z plus 1, may be written in this manner. You can write it z plus 2 होल स्क्वायर माइनस 3. यू कैन चेक इट. एक्चुअली दिस जेड प्लस 2 होल स्क्वायर विल बी जेड स्क्वायर प्लस 4 जेड प्लस 4 एंड 4 माइनस 3 विल बी 1. सो वी कैन राइट इट इन दिस मैनर. नाउ द डिनोमिनेटर ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन यू कैन सी इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. हेयर ए इज एक्चुअली जेड प्लस 2 एंड बी विल बी रूट 3. सो लेट अस सिंप्लीफाई इट बाई यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला फॉर ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. सो वी कैन राइट ए माइनस 1, दैट इज रेसिड्यू ऑफ एफ ऑफ जेड एट इट्स दिस सिंपल पोल. दिस इज लिमिट जेड टेंडिंग टुवर्ड्स माइनस 2 प्लस रूट थ्री जेड प्लस 2 माइनस रूट 3 ओवर. दिस विल बी व्हाट? दिस विल बी जेड प्लस 2 माइनस रूट 3 इंटू जेड प्लस 2 प्लस रूट 3. इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द फॉर्मूला ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. सो यू कैन सी दीज टू फैक्टर्स विल कैंसिल आउट एंड आवर रिजल्ट इज लिमिट जेड टेंडिंग टुवर्ड्स माइनस 2 प्लस रूट 3 वन ओवर जेड प्लस 2 प्लस रूट 3. एंड नाउ लेट अस पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस लिमिट ऑफ जेड. सो व्हाट विल बी दिस? दिस विल बी एक्चुअली इक्वल टू 1 ओवर जेड. एट द प्लेस ऑफ जेड नाउ वी विल राइट माइनस 2 प्लस रूट 3. सो एंड द रिमेनिंग टर्म्स आर 2 प्लस रूट 3. सो यू कैन सी दिस 2 विल कैंसिल आउट and this is actually equal to 1 over 2, 1 over, not 2, yes, 1 over 2 root 3. So this is the residue of this function f of z at its simple pole, which is actually inside this unit circle C. And as I have told you, there is no need to find the residue of this function at the pole which is actually outside of this unit circle. Now we will actually apply the residue theorem for evaluating the integral. So you can see by Cauchy residue theorem. Cauchy residue theorem. We know integral along C f of z dz. This is actually equal to 2 pi I into sum of the residues at all the isolated singular point inside the closed curve C. In this problem, you can see there is only one pole inside the unit circle C. So there will be only one residue term. And so we can write here. Therefore, in this problem, actually integral along C 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1 dz. Actually this is at the place of f of z, and this will be what? This is 2 pi I into residue at the singular point, and we have find already the residue. This is 2 into root 3. So this is what? This is pi I over root 3. pi over root 3. So you can see actually the integral which we have to evaluate is defined here in this equation. You can see in equation 1. So if we have to find the value of this integral I, you can see from this equation 1, we have to multiply by the factor minus 2i to the integral of 1 over z square plus 4z plus 1. So our result will be actually found after multiplying this result by minus 2i. So we can see integral 0 to 2 pi d theta over 2 plus cos theta. And what will be now this? Actually, this will be minus 2i into pi I over root 3. And I into I will be I square, which is minus 1. And so minus minus will cancel out, and this will be simply 2 pi over root 3. So this is answer of our problem. So you have seen how the residue theorem is actually applied in solving such type of integrals. Now let us take another important example to illustrate this concept. So let us evaluate I equal to integral 0 to 2 pi d theta by 5 plus 3 sine theta. You can see this problem is just like the previous problem, and so we will follow the same steps for solving this problem. Here again we will consider a unit circle and define that unit circle in this way. So consider a unit circle C, and this circle C is defined as, you know, z equal to e to the power I theta. And you have already found that in this condition, what is this d theta? We know this is actually minus I dz by z. Simply take the differential, and we have to change the function psi theta in terms of z. And you know this is actually equal to z square minus 1 over 2iz. So now transform the given integral in terms of the complex variable. So you can see I is equal to integral 0 to 2 pi 5 plus, or sorry, this is d theta over 5 plus 3 sine theta. And this can be written as integral along the unit circle C, and this will be 1 over 5 plus 3 sine theta. And you can see here sine theta is actually equal to what? This is actually z square minus 1 over 2iz. And at the place of d theta, we will write what? We will write minus I dz over z. Now let us simplify it. You can see this is actually integral along the unit circle C, Let us take here this 2iz as LCM, and when we will take this as LCM, this will be actually in the numerator here. So this will be 2iz over, and in denominator there will be 3z square plus 10iz minus 3, and here is minus I dz over z. So you can see this z and z will actually cancel out, and I times I will be I square, which is minus 1, so this minus will cancel out, and so the constant factor in here is 2, which will be which can be taken outside of this integral, and so we can write this integral as, therefore we can write I equal to, taking the constant factor 2 in outside of the integral, this can be written as integral along C and 1 over 3z square plus 10iz minus 3dz. Now you can see in this equation 1, we can take this function which is actually to integrate as f of z. So let f of z equal to 1 over 3z square plus 10iz minus 3. And we can write this as 1 over 3z square plus 9iz plus iz, you can see 9iz plus iz will be 10iz minus 3. Now let us take the factors in denominator, and for this we can write it as 3z into z plus 3i, and take here actually this plus I as a constant factor. So this will be z, and you know actually this minus can be written as I square, and we have taken I as a constant factor, so 1i will remain there. So this will be plus 3i, plus 3i, and so we can write it as 1 over z plus 3i into 3z plus 1. So this is actually our f of z. Now we can find the singular points, or you can say poles of this function f of z, and you know these will be actually simple poles, as the factors deciding the poles have a power simply 1. So there will be two simple poles of this function f of z, and what are those? You can equate these factors to 0. So to find poles of f of z, we will take the denominator equal to 0. So we will take z plus 3i into 3z plus I equal to 0, and you can see from here actually there will be two solution, z plus 3i equal to 0, and this implies z equal to minus 3i. So this is one of the poles, and again 3z plus I is equal to 0, and this implies 3z equal to minus I, and so z is equal to minus I by 3. So this is actually the another pole. Now let us represent these two poles in the diagram for a unit circle. Let us take a unit circle in the complex plane. You know, we have this unit circle has the center at z equal to 0, and this is x or real axis, this is I y or imaginary axis. So this is real and imaginary. Now you can see both of these poles are in fact imaginary. So definitely these two poles will lie on this I y axis. Here actually this z equal to minus I by 3 is inside the unit circle. You can see the modulus of this will be actually 1 over 3. So this is less than 1. And so this is the point minus I over 3. Now you can see this point z equal to as it is minus, so in fact it will be in downward direction, not in upward direction. So this point z equal to minus I by 3, this is here, this is minus I by 3, and z equal to minus 3i, this is outside of this circle. Let us take, this is at minus 3i. So you can see only one pole, which is actually z equal to minus I by 3, is inside this unit circle C. The another pole z equal to minus 3i is outside of this circle. So applying the residue theorem, we have to find only the residue of the function f of z at this simple pole z equal to minus I by 3. So only the simple pole z equal to minus I by 3 is inside C, and so a residue of f of z at z equal to minus I by 3 is given as, since the pole is a simple pole, so we will apply the formula for a simple pole which we have learnt in the previous lectures. So you can write this residue as a minus 1 at z equal to minus I by 3, and you know this is actually given as limit z tends to z naught. Here z naught is actually equal to minus I by 3, and inside this bracket there is z minus z naught, and since z naught is minus I by 3, so this will be z plus I by 3 into f of z, and you have seen that this f of z is actually equal to what? This is actually equal to z plus 3, 1 over z plus 3i into 3z plus I. This is in fact f of z. So you can see from here this will be 3z plus I limit z tending towards minus I by 3, and simplify it, this is 3z plus I over 3. So this is 3 into z plus 3i into 3z plus i. Now you can see this 3z plus I will cancel out, and hence our result is limit z tending towards minus I by 3 and 1 over, this is 3 into z plus 3i. Now let us put the limiting value of z, which is actually minus I by 3. So if we will put this limiting value, what will be our result? You can see this is actually 1 over 3 into z. Z is minus I by 3 and plus this 3i, and so this will be in fact 9i minus I over 3, and this 3 will cancel out. So you can see this is actually 1 over 8i. So we have calculated the residue of this function at its simple pole, which is inside the unit circle C, and this residue is what? This is a minus 1 equal to 1 over 8i. Now we will apply the residue theorem for finding the integral, and you can see therefore integral along C f of z dz, and you know actually this f of z is equal to what? This is actually equal to 1 over 3z plus, let us see what is this integral. Actually this integral is 3z plus 1 in 1 over 3z plus 1 into z plus 3. So this is 3z plus I into z plus 3i dz. And in accordance with Cauchy residue theorem, this will be actually equal to 2 pi I into residue at the simple pole, which is inside this. Since there is only one residue, so I am not writing here summation. So this will be 2 pi I into 1 over 8i. And what will be this? I will cancel out, and this will be pi over 4. Pi over 4. So the required integral, required integral, you can see actually the required integral is 2 times of this much. So this will be 2 into pi by 4, and hence this is pi by 2. So this is answer of this problem. I hope from these two examples the concept of finding the integrals of real variables using the concept of calculus of residues in this particular form you have clearly understand, and so you can solve some more problems by following your textbook. And so I suggest you go through your textbook and solve such type of problems, and you can see you will enjoy in solving those problems, because if you have learnt these techniques, this will be very easy for solving such type of problems.